Dear viewers, in this video we are going to look at how the Zoom recording we can do, video recording, what are all the provisions available for annotations and whiteboard tools, and how we may need to change the virtual background and settings for speakers and microphone and headphones. These are all the few features I'm going to demonstrate in this video. First, we need to get into zoom.us website and we need to download Zoom software. It is free for anyone to use. Once if it is downloaded, this Zoom is the icon we used to get in our desktop. I will be sharing the link for downloading Zoom software in the description box. You just click the link, automatically the latest version of Zoom software will get downloaded into your system. Now, once the downloading, there is no other procedure, just enter the URL, then automatically the software will get downloaded. Then we will see this icon on the desktop or in the application, Windows application, we can see that Zoom application, or somewhere on the taskbar it will be available. We need to double click, then you will have this screen. Then we need to click sign in with Google. Then once if we click sign in with Google, it will take us to sign in into any one of the account. We can sign in either edu.in or ac.in or Facebook account or gmail.com account. Then we will see this launch Zoom. Then we may need to enable launch Zoom. Then it will get activated. We will have this screen after launching the Zoom. We need to click new meeting for video recording. Here I am going to demonstrate how to do video recording with the Zoom software. Later on in the subsequent video, I will be explaining how to schedule a meeting and all other stuff. Now we need to click this. Once if we click, we will see this camera enabled mode. Now we need to wait until that connecting is over. Join with the computer audio, we need to click. Once if we click, we need to go here. We need to look at microphone. Select microphone or same as system. It should be either one. Microphone is for any time if you use external speaker or headphones. Same as a system. Once if we use system volume, system output, we can use the same as a system. Similarly, speaker input to the computer. The first one is how we are taking output from the computer. Second one is input to the computer. For this, same as system. Preferably we may need to use, if you are connecting external speakers, we need to use this external speaker. Then nothing more we are going to do with this. Then look at the start video, there is an arrow mark, the pop-up menu. We need to click this pop-up menu. If we want to change the video setting, we need to click this video setting. We need to go here and we need to click virtual background. Here we will have lot of other options. We can explore these all: statistics, keyboard shortcuts and virtual background, recording option, chat options, chat history. If you want to look at, we can look at. Now we need to click virtual background. These are all the virtual backgrounds I have uploaded already from the internet. So this is my institution background. We need to look at, depending upon the background, the color of or appearance of ourselves will change. So we need to select which suits well with our face, we need to choose, or which is the suitable ambience for our video, we can choose. So all the virtual background I have brought already. These are all the possible virtual background I am having it. I am going to choose this one for this video. Now this is over. Just close it. No more settings, no more option. We need to choose any one of the virtual background image. We need to download, and this is the button we need to upload. Click this button. Add image. Any of the image from our desktop we can add. Whichever the image we want, we can add. But the suitable image is picked from the internet, and see the combination, which combination presents your appearance very well, that combination we need to use. Once if it is done, we need to close this. Nothing more we need. If I want to change the background, yes, I can change now, or I want to be with the same background, I can be with it. That's it. Close it. Now everything is ready. Now we started with this option, this pop-up menu for setting the audio. Most of the time we will be changing speaker to headphone, and we don't connect headphone also, speaker also. We used to listen from the laptop speaker. So by that time we need to change these all the possible settings. Only then attending webinar we will say nothing is happening, it is not audible, that kind of issues will not come. We need to look into these options. Similarly, this option, choose virtual background, we need to do. Video settings also we can change, lot of options available. Either we can use video settings or virtual background. We can come here, we can keep doing it, share screen and chat and virtual background. Subsequent video I will explain about these all. Right now this is focused only for how we can create a video. Then once these all the settings are over, audio setting, video settings are over, we need to look at share screen and record. The moment it is clicked, right now I am recording about Zoom software in flashback recorder. If we want to create a record, we need to click record button, record option we need to click. Once if we click record option, the record video will get recorded. If we don't click, the entire articulation will get waste. Now we want to communicate through PPT. By the time we need to click, we need to get opened all the softwares. If we want to articulate any of the online websites, URLs, then that also need to be opened prior to this. Then we need to click share screen. Click the share screen. In that, if we want to articulate with whiteboard, we can do. Always see to that screen, whenever we choose the screen, whatever we do in the computer, everything will be visible to the audience. If otherwise, news share, if you choose particular document, that document will be visible. Now we come here, we need to go for annotation. Whenever we articulate, we may need to explain lot of stuff other than the PPT content. So that annotate, the moment we click annotate, we can see this menu. This menu has mouse, then this menu has this mouse option, select option. This select option is to select some portion and explain. We can't select, just we can mark and we can explain. This is the portion I am explaining, grabbing the attention of the audiences. We can use this select. Then text option. This text option always useful for explaining something. Explain something else other than the PPT. Other than the PPT content, anything which we want to articulate, we can use it PPT content. Now we can change the color also. This is a color palette. These are all the colors available. We can set, always we want to write in bold, we can write. The now only bold is enabled. Similarly, earlier 24 point, we can change 35 also. Formatting. Now, after that change, I'm going to select one more text box. Wherever we want, we can click. After clicking the text box, this is what we will get. Text box formatting style. This so. Now, I have applied bold and I have applied 38. Now, I want to change the color. Yes, it is possible to change the text box formatting style. Any color we can. Before coming out of this text box, we need to change. Now done. Now I'm going to choose this orange color. Now once again I'm going to click text box. Here one text box has come. Orange color. Or else I can change different color. I am going to change green color. Now I'm deleting green color. This is how we can use text box. For the text box, just a single click, formatting is available in the format option. Colors and line width. This line width is to specify. This I will come back. Now next, we can draw. These are all the symbols. Free draw, free line, then straight line, square and circle, then free line and arrow. And double arrow, single arrow, diamond symbol, filled rectangle, filled circle, patterned rectangle, patterned circle. These are all combinations only available. Now let us go to format. We can choose the thickness. This thickness very thin. This will not be good. Most of the time I prefer either this or this, nor this. This will become too thick. The line would become too much of thickness. This will become very mild. People cannot able to notice. The second one is better. Much more that, the third one is better. Now I am choosing. I am going to select the color also. Let me choose yellow color. Then I am going for, I need to come out of this text. I need to change. One click outside, other than the text we need to click. Then whenever we get into text or draw, all the time it will come that either text or draw. Now what I can do, either erase. Now that erase is gone. Spotlight. This spotlight here, we have two different ways of spotlight. either this, the first torch like option we can use, we can explain green color, top down parser, bottom up parser. With this we can do any operation. We can click any of the software, any of the operation we can do. See, any part of the document we can do it. This one, with that we can scroll, we can click any other option. Text I am clicking, spotlight, I am using spotlight. For this I can change the color, black color I am using spotlight. This is called spotlight. This spotlight color we can't change, it comes by default in Zoom, this only. With the Epic Pen we can use different kind of spotlight. With the Zoom we are having only this spotlight. Subsequently this also we can use, but here what is the problem is your name will come. This is how I am spotlighting. This, the moment I move, top down parser, bottom up parser, types of parser, spotlight, text box formatting, wherever we want to explain that portion we can click, that there nearby that we can highlight. But the problem is your name will be disappeared most of the time. So that I used to avoid. If you like you can use. Instead always we can prefer within this arrow we need to shift to spotlight. So if you are in this mode it is spotlight, if you are in this mode it is arrow. So that is spotlight. The spotlight would be comfortable all the time. Second one, draw. If you want to draw this we can draw. This rectangle is over, circle is over, arrow is over. While explaining itself we can draw something, then we can spotlight and explain this is how this block works, this function works, something like that. Any of the image which you like you can do, filled circle and filled rectangle, whatever you like you can do. Next, stamp. This stamp is, I love this parser, we can stamp it. Similarly, this is the direction of learning, this kind of stamp, this is right, this parser is right. Then stamp, question mark, can you answer why this parser is useful, something like that. Stamp, come back, this is wrong, we can mark. So these are all the kind of 6 stamps available. This is excellent. Among all the parser, this is the parser seems to be working well. Like that we can star. That is the topmost parser like that. Then whenever you like the concept, I can say I love this concept. I love these types of parser. So we can give like that. So this is stamp. Spotlight over, eraser. When we click eraser, erasing one element at a time. Erasing this element, this element. When we use clear all drawing, clear my drawing, clear all drawings, gone. Now my document not reflected with whatever I have drawn. So that I am done, I am doing clear all drawings. Eraser, if we choose, for example, I am putting this love mark, 4 love symbols, this all. I can choose eraser, erasing this and this, one item only. If I want to erase everything, I need to go to clear, clear all drawings, over. Undo, redo is also possible. Undo, undo. How much I need to undo? The session is over, we can't do undo. Redo, yes, possible. That's all. These are all the way we can do. Now, I am going to draw something. Finally, I want to take a printout, that screenshot of it. I am writing something, annotating something, step number 1, step number 2, step 1. During presentation I am modifying the PPT and I am explaining a lot. Sometime we may get a lot of sparkling moment beyond even the content preparation. We get a lot of instantaneous way of explanation, instantaneous way of analogy, something like that. Suppose I am telling unique story, all those things we can do. We can do lot of modifications with that. Then stamp I am choosing, lot of stamps I am collecting. Then using spotlight we can come out, with the spotlight only we can come out. Then stamp I am going to use star, these are all the stars. Color of the star I can't change. Then these all, with this I want to share the screen, save the screen. For that I need to click save. Where it will be available in your computer, say screen saved, it is showing, show in folder. Right, immediately if you click it will show in folder. See, the show in folder, this is where I am saving the screen. Every screenshot also, whatever we are annotating, whatever we are writing, that also, see, whenever I am clicking it is coming arrow, I need to choose this, then it will come. So now save is the option to save any part of the screen. Now with this screen, whatever I am writing, after writing I want to save means I need to use save. As many times we want to save, we can save. It will be in the form of image. Later on also, we can share that kind of screens to our students. These are all the possible features. Mouse select. Select is for selecting some portion and explaining, highlighting. Then text is for texting. Draw is for drawing these 12 operations. Options. Stamp has 6 special symbols for stamping activity. Spotlight, 2 spotlight. Preferably try to use this torch light. This torch like spotlight. I am explaining this point, this point, this point, this point. I can talk like that. Then eraser. Eraser is to erase particular item. Any one item you can erase. Now these are all the item I am retaining. This also I want to erase. On top see, I have drawn this arrow. Similarly, this all. Clear is for clearing all the drawings. Then format is to choose the color, line width, bold, italic effect and font size. After choosing the font size, see, I am going to choose 72. I am going to write hi everyone. How much bigger it is coming. So this all you can do. End of video. I am going to complete end of video. End of demonstration, something like that. That is what available in the format. This much larger size, no need to prefer because it will occupy most of our screen, so that we can prefer optimum 24. After 24, it is customized. See, it is enabled. We need to click one more text, then we need to come out and we need to draw. This is next text. Next text I am writing. Then we can change the color. With the focus, if we do, it will change the color. Otherwise, it will not change the color. Yellow color. Now anything, any moment we are getting stuck up, we need to come to spotlight. We need to choose this spotlight torch. Then with this we can move, we can click, we can save the file, we can do all clear, we can close the annotate. Whenever you feel difficult to handle this portion, just bring this annotation tool, keep wherever you want. Similarly, this tool also, Zoom basic tools also, menu options also, you can, both are independent of each other. Where you feel comfortable, you just click on it somewhere and drag and drop and keep where you feel comfortable. I am keeping these two. I want to use this portion so that I can do redo, undo, save. These are all the possible options will be useful for creating video. And whenever we feel like to have cough and we want to have water, somebody is disturbing, record. The moment we put record, recording is happening. Pass record is for passing the record and resume record. Sometime we will forget, we will be without resume record, we will keep articulating, then gone case. So all the time we need to be careful when we apply, when we start the video, record is mandatory. If we are getting disturbed by someone, we need to go and apply pass record. When we come back for the video recording, we need to use, it will be disabled. This green color, red color button only will be visible. Just gentle navigation towards this green and red button we need to go, and more button will come. Then we need to go for resume recording. Then I don't require, yet another software is recording whatever I am doing. Pass record. Now new share. This articulation with this document is over. What I supposed to do? I need to click stop share. When I click stop share, what will happen? See, the entire screen is appeared with our face. For that, we need to always put pass record. Whatever we want to do, when we are switching over from one document to another document, what we are doing, if that should not be noticed by our students in the record or audiences in the record, we need to go with pass record, then share screen, stop screen, share screen. Now I am going to open one more document, that document or whiteboard. I will click whiteboard. This demonstration also let me complete. Whiteboard share. Now we have got plain whiteboard. We can explain one problem with the PPT. In another document we can start writing. This pen, draw pen, we need to choose this. We can explain integral 1 to 4, we can write like this, x dx. It will be tough. It is like a practice how we are doing. If we have digital pen, it is very easier, x dx. So this is the integral step, step number 1. Then we need to go for x square divided by 2 and the square bracket, the range of 1 to 4, this is the step number 2, something like that we always need to do. It is very tedious, so we need to have practice. That is the only thing. Draw option I am using, the first option for these all, underlining and explaining and putting circle and like this. Then text, purely we can start data science. I can write, then the font size is too bigger, I want to reduce, optimum is 24, always 24. I want to change the color, data science, I can go for green. So after data science, supervised learning, whatever we want to do, we can do in this unsupervised learning. We can do the same tools going to be useful in the whiteboard. Whiteboard is useful for explaining with a fresh page without our PPT. We can intervene with whiteboard and our PPT together. For that, this I am introducing. Again, we can save. The moment we click the save button, the entire screen, what we are doing on it, it will get saved. If I want to draw, I can draw something. Filled color. Then I can change this. Now, if we want to change the color of this, we need to change. I think it is not allowing to change the color. Yeah. By default, what it is giving, that only we need to use. Then this color. This color is fixed, whereas these two colors are permitting. Now I am going to do rectangle, another rectangle. This rectangle color I want to fill with green. This is also not changing. Yeah, after this we need to choose. After choosing the color, we may need to choose this. Then it is working. So let me pick this color. Then I'll choose this. Then let us see. Yeah, changing the color. Let me pick black color. Then I'll choose this circle. It is changing. Yes, it is changing. So what is the difference is, this is with the light blurred color. This one exact color. The shadow of this or this is exact one. That is only. First we need to pick the color. Then we need to choose the diagrams. This arrow also. After choosing arrow, it will not come. If we want to draw straightly, press shift key. After pressing shift key, the arrows will be straight. Otherwise, sometimes zigzag it will come. Some zigzag like this it will come. That's all. These are all the options. Spotlight. This spotlight is to explain while explaining what point we are concentrating for that. Select is which portion. For example, we can explain that these are all the point we discussed. This is the equation. This is how it works. Something like that. We can highlight and explain. That's all. So now draw, text, formatting, everything is over. Thank you for watching. Subscribe the channel. Thank you all.